Close your eyes and watch your breath. Keep your mind on the breath. It's because we have some control over the mind that we're able to meditate. We want to make the best use of that. There are a lot of things in the world that we can't control, that we can't change, but the mind is something we can control to some extent and can change to some extent. It's not the case that the mind is one thing and the world is something else. There's a big connection. The world has an impact on the mind has an impact on the world. It's through the intentions of the mind that we act. We do things, say things, think things. And these things have their impact on the world. So you want to make sure they come from a good place. And you're not just reacting. In other words, your mind is not just a little ball in a pinball machine getting knocked around, having no choice as to what it's going to do. The mind does have its choices. And you want to make the most of that. There's a cycle, they say. There's the action, and there's the result of the action, and then the result comes back at you. And then usually there's a defilement, greed, aversion, and delusion based on the result. And then based on that defilement we act. That's where we've got to stop the cycle, the connection between the defilement and the action, or the connection between the result and the defilement. So we start out with thoughts of goodwill. At the very least, when we do something, we want to make sure at least that our intentions are good. Otherwise, if you do something with bad intentions, it comes back at you. It's really hard to live with yourself after a while, because you know you meant ill to the other person, and that's going to come back at you. But if you mean well, at least you've got a toehold in saying, well, I meant well to begin with. And the next part of the equation is, well, did I do it skillfully? And that's where you have to learn from your mistakes. We all make mistakes. But the question is, are we going to learn from them or not? There's that line from Calvin and Hobbes, where Hobbes is observing Calvin's behavior and said, live and don't learn is our motto. For a lot of people, that's the way it is. They just do things the way they want. Or as Talleyrand said about the Bourbons, they never forgot anything, but they never learned anything. That's not the kind of people we want to be. We make a mistake, we want to recognize it as such and then learn how to correct for it so we don't repeat the mistake again. That's what turns our good intentions into skillful intentions. So we start with metta, and they work on this process the Buddha calls purification. It's not a ritual purification, it's simply a purification of our actions to make sure that our good intentions really do lead to good results. So if you take this part of the training, starting with goodwill and then looking at your actions, it can clean up a lot of the stuff in the world around you, both in the world inside your mind and the world outside you. And that's how we can be a positive force for change.